Another announcement from the state of North Carolina, another chamber report in your email inbox. Hello again, everybody. Welcome into another Boone Area Chamber of Commerce Chamber Report. I'm President and CEO David Jackson. Thank you for joining us here tonight, clicking on the link. We will try to make this brief, but just want to make sure that you understand kind of what comes next here in the continued assessment of COVID-19 data throughout the state and what Governor Roy Cooper and Secretary Mandy Cohen announced today as North Carolina's next step forward and trying to help stop community spread. So let's get into that conversation here pretty quickly. Today, the state of North Carolina announcing a new county alert system to help pinpoint counties with the highest levels of viral spread and offer specific recommendations to help bring those numbers down. This system will help give local leadership another tool to use to understand how their county individually is faring and how to make decisions to slow viral spread within those county lines. There will be a map that we will show you here momentarily that will be updated every 4 weeks that has some different metric information that goes into giving a county a profile. And we'll share that information with you here in just a second. But this is really kind of maybe a step in the direction of a process that we heard about back in the spring where the state was considering ways to maybe regionalize some of the impacts to areas based on their amount of viral spread. So heard about that as a process where maybe one side of the state or one particular region within the state might not see as much community spread versus another, that the whole state wouldn't necessarily be working under the same set of rules. This is kind of a tip in the hat in that direction, though not quite all the way there. When I say that, I make reference to some overall guidelines that are being shared with everybody, and then including further guidelines and further steps to be taken by those counties that maybe are experiencing more spread than others. So that's quite an introduction, right? Let's go ahead and get to the meat of our main course here tonight. I'm going to do a screen share with you here just to kind of go over some of this information that comes from state of North Carolina today and Governor Roy Cooper's press conference. You can find all of the documentation that supports this on our relaunch and recovery page at boonechamber.com. No one specific metric gives the complete picture. Dr. Cohen has said that all along. So the county alert system will use three different sets of metrics to kind of communicate what a county's overall situation is. And for the most part, those things are pretty similar to what we have seen in terms of data points that have been shared early on. So case rate is going to be one of those metrics. And you see that detailed here as the number of new cases in 14 days per 100,000 people. Percent positive. That is a fairly easy one to understand. Percent of tests that are positive over a 14-day period of time. This hospital impact number is a little bit different for us to digest because it's just really a new spin on the data. And this is a composite score based on the impact that COVID-19 has had on hospitals, including a percent of COVID hospitalizations, COVID-19 related visits to the emergency department, staff open hospital beds, and critical staffing shortages over a 14-day period of time. Those numbers themselves will go into what that hospital impact looks like. I would pay particular attention to this critical staffing shortages line right here, because that is an element that has not been talked about as much as some of the direct, you've got COVID, you're in the hospital kind of conversation that's been going on. Many hospitals around rural counties especially have been dealing with the fact that their staffs are short due to amount of work spent. You know, they need to give their crews a break, or in some cases, crew members or staff members are becoming infected. So therefore, they are out of the available pool of work resources for a while. So hospitals all throughout the state have been dealing with this, right? Making sure that they have enough critical staff to handle not only care for COVID patients, but for all the other stuff that goes on inside the hospital operation on a day-to-day basis. So the state is going to be looking at that number as part of their metric to deliver that hospital impact. So there are three color codes of counties that are going to be shown to you on this map. The yellow counties are the ones that have significant community spread. Substantial community spread counties will be labeled orange. Critical community spread labeled labeled red. And those are really those high impact spots or those high points of viral spread that we heard the governor referring to. You can see here on this graphic that there are specific thresholds that counties must meet to get elevated from yellow to orange to red. You're going to see evidence of yellow, orange, and red around our area of Northwest North Carolina. So let's pay attention to all of these. In order to get elevated from the baseline level, and that's yellow, you would have to see a case rate to become an orange county, 100 to 200 cases per 100,000 over a 14-day period. You're looking at a percent positive rate in the 8 to 10% range. And then that hospital impact number, which there is really no published number to us, that hospital impact number, though, to those that understand that metric, would be labeled as a moderate impact on the county's hospital. You have to have in order to be moved into a county, you have to meet the case rate threshold. That's easy to say. Have to meet that threshold and then have one of those other two metrics be met, either the percent positive or the hospital impact number. So then look at the red. The red sees a higher case rate, 200 cases or more per 100,000 folks, a greater than 10% positivity rate and a high impact on county hospitals. Now, again, counties that do not meet that criteria for red or orange are categorized as yellow tier counties. They should continue to remain vigilant to prevent further spread and to prevent elevation of where their numbers are. So let's go through some of these individual actions real quick, and then we'll show you the map. Individual actions that are meant for all counties. You see yellow broken out as all individuals. Individuals in red and orange counties are broken out appropriately. I'm not going to go through and read all of this to you. You guys are smart. You clicked on your email, right? But all of these graphics are available, linked in your email here, and also available on our relaunch and recovery page. So I urge you to take a look at some of these. I'm going to hit on some operational high points for yellow counties, because that's where Watauga County comes in at this point in time. But I can tell you, we've got an orange county in Ashe County right next to us. We've got a red county in Avery County right next to us on the other side. So we need to pay attention to all of these metrics and understand that our counties, we know a lot of cross-pollination and people that live in one and work in another or travel frequently from one to another or perhaps through another. So we can understand these things to be good practices to have moving forward as a community. You see, a lot of this is based on prevention. So continuing to emphasize the three W's, continuing to emphasize the download of the Slow COVID NC app. This is, again, the app that the state put together to help people understand when they are in close proximity to somebody who has a COVID positive test. It is a free app that you can download on your phone that does not take GPS tracking and store that. This is basically something that works through Bluetooth technology to alert you to whether you are near somebody that also has the app, also has said that they have contracted the virus and they've got their technology on. So it's a little bit harder maybe to universally deploy, but the information should make you feel safe about the fact that you're not being tracked too much in this process. So Slow COVID NC app, that is something that the state continues to urge folks to do. Those of you that were on our Vision Northwest North Carolina Focus on Our Future series event yesterday and heard Dr. Mandy Cohen speak, she alluded to a few of these things that we heard today in her comments yesterday and really leaned heavily yesterday on getting the flu shot and talked about that being something that employers especially could help provide their employees and be a very tangible benefit for those employees at this point in time, whether that looks like encouraging your employees to go buy a medical provider and get that, or in some cases, holding a safe and responsible flu shot testing event at your place of business. Those things are available and you can contact a variety of healthcare partners that can help you with that. But the flu shot is listed on there. Getting tested if you're symptomatic, the state making sure to include some language in this, again, about making a priority on testing before Thanksgiving for everybody that knows they're going to be in a traveling situation. And again, looking at the community opportunities to do that, whether they're partners through the health department, a place like Boone Drug Incorporated, who has made community testing something that they have worked into their workflow and offerings, and various other partners throughout the community. We'll point out a website that you can get to get some of that information in there as well. So some of this all individual information, that is pretty easy to understand. Avoid large gatherings, eliminate non-essential travel. When you look over on the red side, though, this is where things get a little bit more specific, and the red and orange, about limiting mixing between households and minimizing the number of people in your social circle. We kind of have a joke in our house. We refer to our circle of folks as our germ pod. We know where they've been, they know where we've been, and that kind of works. Folks have done that. You know, we've all been resilient in that way, but you want to limit as many people. If you're in one of those red or orange counties or are traveling to one of those counties, may want to consider that. Avoiding settings where people congregate and congregate in high numbers. If you're patronizing restaurants, consider takeout from restaurants or eating outdoors when possible here in this area, especially socially distanced. Making sure that high risk loved ones are taken care of, and anybody that is high risk, maybe limiting their activities as well. So it's really kind of all individual action type things. The important part to this, and really the bulk of the rest of our conversation, is going to center around the business and community organization actions. These are steps that we can take as business leaders, business owners, staff members, to make sure that we are doing our part to help communicate this very important message. So part of that comes from, again, encouraging the practice of the three W's. And I don't have to tell you what they are, but I will anyway. Wear that mask, wash your hands, wait 6 feet. You will see a renewed emphasis in the Show Your Love campaign coming up here over the next several weeks because of the heightened travel season to the mountains. This was one of those periods of time where the leadership at App Healthcare, along with the other chambers of commerce around the area, specifically pinpointed this time, right around Thanksgiving to right around the end of the year, where we want to double up on that messaging with the Show Your Love campaign and reminding those that are visiting our area, treat our community like you treat your own, right? You know, pay attention to the three W's. Understand that this community has got its own health challenges. Don't bring your challenges to us. Try to adhere to the policies that have been set forth statewide and help keep our community as healthy as possible while you're visiting here, but also encouraging people to say, hey, we've got businesses here that are doing the things that they are supposed to be doing and doing them well. So you should feel good about coming here because of some of those things that have been implemented. So you'll see more signage. You'll see more conversation about the three W's. You'll see more opportunities for employers to request PPE. If that becomes an issue, for the most part, at least around here locally, supply chain for PPE has not been as big of a concern here over the last several months. The state will bring out their business toolkit, a lot of those resources available on our relaunch and recovery website, thinking about, again, ways to message, ways to get PPE, ways to encourage employees and customers to interact within your store. This is another area for you to really consider your curbside options and things along those lines as we move into the holiday shopping season. Going back and visiting some of those tried and true things that got you through the spring. Curbside pickup, ordering online and picking up real quick, kind of quick in and out type thing. I don't think this is going to be the holiday season for browsing in person, but that doesn't mean that it can't be the holiday season for browsing your inventory online and coming in and making that quick purchase. So those are some of the things that are highlighted in the toolkit. One of the things the state is doing is really emphasizing that when possible, people should consider remote work options, especially throughout the rest of the calendar year. And I think that comes on a couple of different levels, right? Number one, a number of businesses, including our own, have continued remote work options because it works well within our workflow. We've always got somebody here every day at the chamber, but we work one person in the office every day. We work in our own workstations and we rotate through our staff list to make sure that we're not all in here on top of each other. Some businesses understand that with travel and not having the opportunity to maybe quarantine staff when they come back from grandma's house or wherever they're going, that it might just be easier to flip their workflow home for this period of time because at this time of year, there's a lot more back and forth. And that could be a very smart option for you as well, as long as you've got the workflow that supports that. So as you read through these guidelines on the business side, please take note of some of the resources that are available. Promote the Find My Testing Place website, and that is where you can go and find public testing options as well as some private resources in the individual communities where you live in. I would also reiterate the Count on Me NC training, and for, again, some of the same reasons that we saw back at the onset of the summer. Remember we told you then, as people begin to travel around, they're going to look for things that promote safety. Count on Me NC training promote safety. And there's a website, almost like a clearinghouse of businesses that have been through those protocols that can provide some sort of assurance that staff has been trained on safety procedures and that your business is leaning forward with those things. And the State Tourism Board continues to tell us this. All of the tourism partners continue to tell us this. People are doing more research than ever about your business operation, and they want to know that you're following safety procedures. This is not a political issue. This is a business issue. If you want to do more business, adhere to these guidelines, because this is what the marketplace is telling you that they want to see. And Count on Me NC training is a very easy step to take to put yourself on a list of businesses that are adhering with these policies. So if you're adopting them already, it makes all the sense in the world to make sure that people understand that you are. Some people have talked about App State operations here in Watauga County. Institutes of higher education have been asked if they are in orange or red counties, not inclusive of Watauga at this point, to adopt stricter restrictions on student gatherings and events. Talked a lot more about implementation and enforcement of those policies, close indoor dining and move to grab and go. A lot of those operations already taking place now. I think off this list, you will see more language coming out of App State about testing available for students before they leave the community so they know they're not taking the virus home with them. And then we'll see some additional language come out after the beginning of the year about testing as they come back to our community as well. And I know that there are several of you that have expressed that concern already about what that may look like. And the state is making more resources available for campuses to be able to handle that load along with other local healthcare partners. Final thing here in this, and again, I promised not to be too lengthy and shot right through that. So public officials have some options here as well. And I want you to be very attentive to this. They will be encouraged, as we all are, to promote the three W's, to actively practice those three W's, lead by example, work with local media to share the importance of practicing the three W's exercises that we're doing right now, encourage people to download the Slow COVID NC app. But on the red and orange county side, this is where I want you to pay some attention, because this is kind of the, if things continue to trend in the wrong direction, this is what we all may face. You look at counties being able to discuss plans with state officials, as they have been all along, to help mitigate spread, work with the state to expand no-cost testing to residents, especially prior to holiday travel. We've seen evidence of that in our community. More testing, more types of testing available already. Work with the state to increase the availability of non-congregate housing. We've seen that step into the university side as well in talking about housing operations for some campuses around the state moving forward. The one that I really want to pay attention to here is adopt ordinances that allow for the use of civil penalties for enforcement or statewide restrictions, increasing enforcement of mass gathering limits, masks with local law enforcement or other regulators or an inspector such as a fire marshal maybe to come in on some of these things. Consider adopting additional local ordinances, whether that's about alcohol sales and on-site consumption or additional restrictions for public-facing businesses. These are things that orange and red counties are having to deal with. I say this to you because there are orange and red counties around us, so don't be surprised if there are some business model modifications that go on in some of those businesses here in the near future. But understand too that public officials now have that tool available to them again in a very public way, that if trends get too far down the road, they've got support from the state to make changes at a local administrative level if that's what needs to happen. So I don't mean that in a threatening way by any standpoint, because that's not what we're about. We're trying to share the information with you so you can delineate what the different policies and procedures may mean from one category to another. But just understand that we're kind of to that point. We haven't seen it here. We haven't seen the numbers creep up in this community currently that some other areas of the state, particularly the Triad area, are seeing right now. So while this may seem a little bit kind of behind the time, right? We saw this bump for ourselves a few weeks ago. Now we're seeing a little bit more of that that bump in numbers across the state, and you're seeing a lot more pointed conversation about things that we may have seen already in our own community. Here is a look at the map, though, and as you can see, red counties, orange counties all the way around us. Caldwell County in the orange, as is Ashe. You see Avery immediately to the to the south and west of Watauga County in the red, as is Wilkes. Quite a bit of spread, as you see, coming out of the triad communities west. That was something that Dr. Cohen mentioned. And a lot of this color coding, as she mentioned today, some of those counties going over the threshold, really on the hospital resource side of things. That hospital impact was one of the things that pushed over. So I want to highlight a few: low impact on the hospital in Ashe County, but you see the positivity rate at 8.7%. We'll move down the list for our W counties down here. Watauga County at 3.8% positivity rate, low impact on the hospital, about 235 cases on average during the period. You see Wilkes in the critical red at 10.5% on the positivity rate. And you can scroll through this full list and get a full impact. Go back up to the top here for just 1 second and highlight Avery County on this list, 11.3%. 14-day percent positive. The state is going to update these metrics every month. So about 4 weeks from now, we will see this guidance on individual county numbers updated. So that won't move. You don't have to keep clicking refresh on that. We will still continue to see guidance from the state on how they expect people to be able to take data and make community-wide decisions. There will be more activity, I believe, between the state and our local county and municipal governments about things that they may see and action steps that may need to be taken. Lot to say, lot to share, lots of links in your email here tonight. The importance here is while we are very much encouraged by vaccine development, Dr. Cohen mentioned that during our Vision Northwest North Carolina event yesterday, that is something really to be excited about. Not quite there yet. There are states around us and significantly away from us that are going through many more restrictive measures at this point in time. And what we don't want to see is any kind of regression. We absolutely do not want to see businesses being forced by the state or other government to have to drastically alter their operations plans now. This is too important of a time for us. We've come too far. We have established so many good practices here to keep ourselves healthy, our community healthy. We feel like we can do this. And part of that is going to be showing that we can do it by practicing the three W's, by preaching the safety element to our staffs, by leading with that towards our customers as well, and making sure that they understand that that Watauga County, the high country, our surrounding area is a place that they can feel good about coming to in a safe and responsible manner. That is going to manifest itself quite a bit here because we've got choose and cut season that we're in the middle of right now. We see more and more. I'm sure this weekend we will see more trees on cars than we'll see cars without trees. We will also see very soon the start of the ski season. I know Beach Mountain had their guns going earlier. I'm sure all of them will have snowmaking capabilities cranked up and wide open here over the course of the next several nights. So we'll see more traffic in that regard as well. So with more people coming in, I think a real subtle reminder again about practicing what we preach, talk about the three W's, show yourselves as an example of that in the business community, and we can get through this patch and get back to the things that we know that we can do so well in this community. That's welcome others, be welcoming toward one another, continue to support our local business efforts, and try to get us economically moving in the right direction once again. So thank you for indulging us on this video. It was certainly longer than it was intended. There's a lot of information that I encourage you to go down in your email, look over those links, and please feel free to contact us with any questions. I know a number of you are tired of hearing this. We're tired of talking about it. We'd love to talk about so many other things and are encouraging you to share your silver linings with us. We've got some things coming up toward the end of the year that I think will put a more positive spin on what has been a very difficult year for many. So be looking forward to that. And just continue to do what you're doing. Show your love. Show the fact that this community thinks about each other incredibly well. That is what's gotten us through this point, and that's what will get us through this. So if there's anything that we can do to connect you to resources, please let us know. On behalf of the entire chamber staff, I'm David Jackson saying good night. We're done with your email for this evening. You can delete, click refresh, check out whatever shopping deals you've got. Shop local for the holidays too. Take care, everybody.